Hello everyone, welcome back again to FN Engineering channel. Today, we are going to design piping equipment, especially for pipe thickness calculation as per SME B31.3. Many industries have piping equipment, so this calculation will be commonly used by many engineers. In this video, we will explain step by step how to calculate pipe thickness calculation under internal pressure. Moreover, we suggest you to watch this video until the end, so you will receive this information completely. Well, here are the overview of this video. First of all, we will briefly explain what SME B31.3 is. Then, we will find the applicable reference, symbols, and definition to calculate pipes. After that, we will give the minimum required data to design piping. In the last session, we will practice with study case problems and their solutions. Alright, before we continue, please support this channel by subscribing FN Engineering channel and like our video. Thank you. SME B31.3 is the SME standard to design process piping. This standard is commonly used in some applications such as petroleum refineries, chemical plants, pharmaceutical plants, textile, paper, semiconductor plants, and rapid processing plants. This picture shows the illustration scope of SME standards. Some equipment within the scope of SME B31.3 uses the bold line symbol, including package equipment piping, piping of pressure vessels, piping of heater, and piping of boiler, which is excluded to confirm B31.1. Go to the next slide. In this slide, we will show the use reference, symbols, and definition to design piping. In general, we use two equations, which are equation 3A and equation 3B, which are located in chapter 2 or design. Equation 3A is used when the outside diameter value is known. Meanwhile, equation 3B is used when the inside diameter is known. Then, we will define all symbols in this equation. T is required thickness using millimeter unit. P is internal design pressure using MPa unit. S is lower stress from appendix A. We can obtain this value from appendix A, table A1 for customary unit, or table A1M for SI unit. Uppercase D is outside diameter. Meanwhile, lowercase d is inside diameter. E is the quality factor from appendix A, table A1A for casing material, and table A1B for others material. W is weld joint strength reduction factor from table C02.3.5. C is mechanical allowance, including corrosion allowance, strain allowance, and erosion allowance. Lastly, Y is the coefficient from table 304.1.1 for thickness less than the ratio of outside diameter divided by 6. For thickness equal or greater than D per 6 using this equation. Next, here are the required data for calculating pipe using SME B31.3. They are internal design pressure, internal design temperature, outside or inside diameter, and pipe material. Now, turn on to the study case. In this case, we will calculate pipe under internal pressure based on the previous explanation. We have some given data such as internal descent pressure 1.5 MPa, internal descent temperature 100 degrees Celsius, nominal pipe size 4 inch, and material using SA106 grade B. Alright, we are going to solve the study case. In this case, we use the equation 3A because the outside diameter is given. First of all, we define the value of each symbol. P, or internal descent pressure, is 1.5 MPa. D, or outside diameter, is 114.3 millimeters from SMEB 36.10. S, or robust stress, is obtained from table A1M, which is 138 MPa at 200 degrees Celsius. E, or quality factor, is 1, which is obtained from table A1B. W, or joint strength reduction, is 1 from table T02.3.5. Y, or coefficient, is 0.4, which is got from table T04.1.1. Moreover, don't forget to consider corrosion allowance, or C. We assume 3 mm for corrosion allowance. In the next step, we calculate T, or required thickness, with this value. We get 3.62 mm for the required thickness. Then, we determine the nominal thickness based on the required thickness. We assume the nominal thickness is 6.02 mm or schedule 40 from SME B36.10. From the nominal thickness, we calculate the finished thickness because we have to consider 12.5% pipe tolerance. So, we get 5.27 mm for the required thickness. Lastly, it is the conclusion. We have to compare the value of the required thickness and the finished thickness. The design is acceptable if the finished thickness is greater than or equal to the required thickness. We can see the finished thickness, or 5.27 mm, is greater than required thickness, 3.62 mm. Well, we have solved the study case problem. In the next video, we will try to calculate this calculation in the spreadsheet or Excel file, inshallah. Alright everyone, thank you for watching my video. If you have some comments or suggestion, please write under comment column. If you get something new from this video, please like my video, subscribe to my channel, and turn on the notification from this channel to get updated video from FN Engineering channel. See you next time.